Hello student. Today we are going to discuss about another more topic that is called as evolution in our second video chapter. So evolution. So that can be described as there is a change in the inherited characteristics of biological population over the successive generation. So when the evolutionary process is viewed as one diversity at every level of biological organization, including the species involve individual organisms and molecules such as DNA and proteins. So where the origin of life. So here the earth, it is a composition. So where there has been formed by a huge explosion called as Big Bang theory. So where it is helpful for the formation of huge clusters of stars called as galaxies. So here the Milky Way galaxy where the earth has been situated. The prebiotic environment of our Earth is consisting of numerous hot gaseous molecules that are spinning around in its own axis. So where, and that the gaseous molecule it has been slowly condensed into a water molecule, liquid molecule, and then into a solid state. So here, the origin of life is considered as a unique event in the history of an universe. So here, the Big Bang theory explains the origin of universe. So where the universe it has been expanded, the temperature decreases and hydrogen, helium were formed sometimes later. So where the solar system of a Milky Way galaxy where the Earth was supposed to be have been formed about 4.5 billion years back. So there are many theories that need to be, that has been explained the origin of life by many scientists. So the first one is there is a theory of special creation. So this theory describes that. So here, the God, it was assuming that the life has been created by the God. That is, even the plants, animals, even the earth, all planets, and even the stars have been created by the God. That is a theory that was proposed called special creation. So next one, the theory of panspermia or cosmozoic theory. So this theory states that the spores from the other planets, when it comes over the surface of Earth, they get converted into one living organisms. So the next one is the theory of spontaneous generation. So this theory states that the living organisms existed in a spontaneous manner. So even here, there are another two theories that is called biogenesis and abiogenesis. The abiogenesis that states that the living organisms are existed from non-living substances, but it has been disproved by the process of biogenesis, where the biogenesis it explains that the origin of life, it has been existed from pre-existing life. So here, the biogenesis has been described by numerous scientists, that is, Louis Pasteur, by the help of Swan-Nakerflask, and Francisco Redi, and Spallanzani. So another theory, that is called theory of chemical evolution of life. So this theory has been explained by scientists, so named called as Stanley Miller and Harold Urey. So for this experiment, they concluded an experimental proof by the help of a spark discharge apparatus. What does the theory of chemical evolution of life it states? So here, the living organisms or origin of life has been existed from the inorganic compounds, that is an organic and even an inorganic non-living components. So for this, the experiment has been conducted by the help of a glass operator, which is called as spark discharge apparatus. So by the help of vacuum pump, the air that was present in the glass apparatus that need to be removed first. So for first round bottom flask, the water need to be added. And for another gas chamber, so that is a methane, ammonia and hydrogen, it has been added in a specific ratio. So when the water it gets boiled to 100 degree of temperature, it was liberating a water vapor. Where this water vapor, it circulates in a clockwise manner. So when the water vapor it reaches the gas chamber, so where the spark has been discharged by the help of an electrode. So where the gaseous molecule they get condenses. So in the condenser, where the organic acids or organic biomolecules they get accumulated in a trap. So in the form of liquid droplets. So there is a basic component where the origin of life has been existed from an organic components. That is, the organic components that was present in the trap are aspartic acid, glutamic acid, even the nucleotides. The nucleotides are the basic components of life that is helpful for the formation of DNA. So this assumption explains that the prebiotic environment of Earth, which consisting of hot gaseous molecule, by the condensation in the form of rainwater, it falls on the Earth's surface. So in the water media, the first living organism has been existed. So this theory also explains that the first living organisms existed from abiogenesis, that is from non-living factor. But after that, it was following down biogenesis, where the living organisms were existed from pre-existing life itself. So next one, there is an evolution of life. So here, the evolution of life has been described by the Charles Darwin, who is called as father of evolution. So when he conducted a voyage for 5 years, nearly in a ship named called as HMS Beagle throughout the world, so he came to the conclusion that the existing living organisms, they are sharing the similarities to varying degrees, not only among themselves, even but with the life forms that was existed millions of years ago. So he said that the extinction of different life forms took place, also new forms of life arose at different parts of history of an earth. So here, the evidence for evolution. So some of the evidence for evolution, in that the first one is paleontology. What is meant by paleontology? It is the study of fossils. The fossils are the remains of an plant or an animals. So they are usually found in the sediments of rocks. So here, the paleontology is the study of fossils that are found in the rocks to support the organic evolution. So where it is helpful for the geological time period with the organisms that have been differentiated into eras, epochs, and even the periods. So where the organisms are existed, the life forms, it varies over a time, and even it has been restricted certain geological lifespan. So here, the new life forms that have been appeared at a different time, it is the history of Earth. So it is on a photocopy where the fossil imprints have been appeared. So next one, that is an embryology. That is a study of embryo. So this theory, it has been described by Ernst Haeckel. So where he described that, for to study the evolution of an organisms, so the embryological development, it helps. But this theory has been disproved by Ernst von Baer. So because he noted that the embryos never pass through the adult stages of other animals. So here, there is an Ernst Haeckel explained that the evolutionary of an individual, it was related based on the embryological study. So because, so there is a common features among these embryos, there is in a fish, reptile, bird, and in a human, there is an appearance of gill slits and tail. But it has been disproved by another scientist. Another one, that is called comparative anatomy and morphology. So we know that the anatomy nothing but the study of internal structure, the morphology nothing but the study of external features. So here, so for to compare the anatomy and morphology, so here there are two types, there is an homology and analogy, which is nothing but the convergent evolution and divergent evolution. So where homology is a relationship among the organisms of different groups of an organism that shows the similarities in basic structure and embryo development, but difference in function. So simply we can give a definition for homologous organs. The organs which are having a similar origin, but they are performing a different functions. So for this we can give an example, there is a four-limb of man, bat. So they are having a same origin and they are performing a different function. So for bat it is helpful for flying, for human beings it is helpful for a locomotory organ. So this is an example for an homologous, there is a four limbs of a different individual. So all have been originated from a same, and even the anatomical features is also same, but they are performing on different functions. So whereas in plants, there is a thorns in a bougainvillea, there is a tendrils in a cucurbita. So both have been originated from the axillary nerve, but they are performing a different function. Here, the thorns help for providing the support or protection for a plant. Here, the cucurbita is helpful for supporting a mechanical support. So next one, there is an analogy. So it is a relationship among the organisms of our different groups of organisms performing the same function irrespective of structural and the anatomical difference. So here, analogous organs means the organs having a different origin but they are performing the same function. So for this example, there is an eyes of octopus and eyes of human beings. So here they have been originated in a different manner, but they are performing the same function, that is for vision. So here the wings of birds and even the wings of insects, originally it was different, but they are performing same function. function that is helpful for flying purpose. So here the tubers of potato and the tubers of sweet potato, they have been originated in a different manner. One is cell modification, another one is an adventitious route, but both they are performing helpful for storage of food menu. So next one, here all the living organisms they consisting of biomolecules which are similar. So we can consider the molecule of homology. It refers to the similarities in biomolecules of all the different kinds of an organism, even the biogeography. So here the living organisms that they have been existed on our surface, it was usually relating on the geographical surface. So where the differential geographical distribution of different organisms, it was indicating a common or shared ancestry in a restricted region. So here there is an evidence for natural selection. So this natural selection is also described by a scientist called as a Charles Darwin. So for this example, that is a industrial melanism. So it is a process that has been taken an example in England. So where there is before industrialization and after industrialization, by taking an example of an insects or moths called Bistrum betularia and Bistrum corbifera, they are commonly called as dark winged moth and melanic moth, and grey winged or white winged moth. So where before industrialization, when the environment was free from pollution, so where the tree barks are covered by the help of lichens. So where the white winged moth, when they are seen over the surface of an plant material, so they cannot be easily distinguished or identified by the birds, but the dark winged moth has been identified by the birds that acts like a predators. So before industrialization, the population of an Bistrum betularia was more and corbifera was less, so due to a natural selection. After industrialization, when the soot, aerosol that has been discharged from the industries, so that they are helpful for removing of lichens. So in that pair, so the white winged moth has been easily identified by the predators, but dark winged moth has been escaped. So this is an example for natural selection. So next one, there is an adaptive radiation. So it is an evolutionary process in which an ancestral stock gives rise to a new species in a given geographical area, where that is from starting point or literally radiating to an other geographical areas. So for this, one of the scientists, so that is an Alfred Wallace, that is rather, that is a Darwin finches. So these are the birds that has been observed by an Darwin, that is in a Galapagos island. Even the species are same. So based upon their food nature, their beak modifications are different. So this is called as adaptive radiation. So here, these are the same species that are called as Darwin finches. So some are eating the seeds and some are eating the fruits, that is called frugivorous. And some they are vegetarian finches which are eating the birds, and some are insectivorous. So based on the beak food nature, the beak has been completely adapted for specific nature. So this is called as adaptive radiation. So adaptive radiation, another one example that is called as Australian marsupials. The marsupial nothing but the pouched mammals. Even they are relating to the same species, but based on the geographical distribution, they have been showing a parallel evolution from one region to another region. So the example for that is a marsupial mammals, or even a placental mammals. So they give an example in a photo. So next one, there is a Lamarck theory of evolution. Along with Darwin, another scientist who is called as Lamarck, they describe the evolution by using different concepts. And then the first one is use and disuse theory. So when we are going to use our specific organs in our body, its lifespan is also increases. For this use theory, they took an example of an giraffe. So when the grassland was more, that is before industrialization or urbanization, so the neck of a giraffe was less. So when they start feeding on the leaves on a plant, so slowly they start stretching their necks, that was initiating a larger phenomena progressively. In one generation, they having a long neck giraffe. So when they start using again and again, the neck become an elongated. This is called as a used theory. Another one, this we call disused theory. The example that is called as snake. So which usually the snake is a reptile. The reptile is usually consisting of an limbs, but the snake was limbless reptile. Due to its burrowing habitat, so the limbs has been reduced or disappeared in one of the generation. that was usually occurs by a process called as mutation. So mutation, it is an sudden heritable change that occurs in an gene sequence. Here, it is an basic component or a raw material for evolution. If there is no evolution, then there is not evolution. Mutation does not occur at evolutionary aspects. Here, the mutation concept has been explained by a scientist named Hugo J. Veris by taking an example of a plant called as Union primrose. That is the biological name of Union primrose, that is an Oenothera lamarckiana. So here, mutation, it occurs in a single step. So it called as single step, it leads to a large mutation. So we are describing by a process called as salvation. So here, D. Veris had explained that the evolutionary process, it occurs at random and it was directionless. But Darwin describes that the variations were small and it was directional. So another one that is called Hardy-Weinberg principle. This principle states that there is a different population that remain the same constant population for many generations, even with an irrespective of external pressure. So for this, there is some of the allelic frequency, there is frequency that equal the changes in a given population. It has been described by an algebraic equation that is called as P plus Q whole square. So here the P and Q, they are the two populations, they are showing different organisms. So where when there are continuous alteration it occurs, even they are remaining in a genetic equilibrium, that can be described as P square plus 2PQ plus Q square equals to 1. This is stated. Even there is a complete alteration or many alteration occurs in a population, that remains constant for generation to generation. But Hardy-Weinberg principle, it does not remain constant because due to some of the factors, it can be varies. So here, the factors that was affecting the Hardy-Weinberg principle, which is also called as neo-Darwinism, by some of the factors like there is a gene migration, there is a flow of gene from one population to another gene population, the genetic drift, which involves some random changes in an allelic frequency that is in an population. The next one is mutation, it is a raw material for evolution, a recombination. So it is a combination of genes that was occurring during the crossing over that occurs usually in a cell division called as meiosis. Natural selection is a main process of evolution. So where it is a most critical evolutionary process that leads to the changes in an allele frequency and it favors for promote the adaptations as a product of evolution. So here natural selection it was usually lead to one speciation. Speciation nothing but the origin of new species. So those organisms which are stronger and they start surviving in a particular environment by showing some of the variation and adaptive process, they start showing a natural selection by producing a new organism called as speciation. So there is a history of evolution of organisms. The first living cell that has been created in a water media is a first cell. So from that slowly the living organisms has been existed. Along the same time, there is a fish that has been caught in a water media called as coelacanth or logfish. They are the ancestors of modern day frogs and salamanders. They are linking between the amphibians and even the reptiles called as logfish. So these amphibians, they have been evolved into reptiles. So after the reptiles, the reason the birds and the mammals have been developed. So this is a fossil imprint of a gained reptile which is called as dinosaurus. That has been usually they become a mass extinct about 65 million years ago. So this is an example for the first mammal which has been identified. So in a South American region called as shrews. So this is an example for the fossils that are called lycopods and psilophyton. So which is an example for pterophytes. Usually the people call pterophytes as fossils of a plant kingdom. The imprints that have been formed in sedimentary rocks. So it is an evolution of man. So man, where there is 15 million years ago, the primates that they lived on an earth surface, they are called as Dryopithecus and Ramapithecus. So again, so there are evolution, in an human evolution, there are different types of there is an Australopithecians, Homo habilis, Homo erectus, Homo sapiens and Homo sapiens again. So here, based upon their brain capacity and their different features, So they have been distinguished into different forms. So let us discuss about some of the MCQs in this chapter. That is, our first one is abiogenesis, theory of origin supports. Abiogenesis, nothing but the living organisms have been existed from non-living substance. So here, spontaneous generation, the first option. Next is origin of life from blue-green algae. Blue-green algae, nothing but the cyanobacteria. The origin of life is due to pre-existing organisms. So here, the origin of life is due to pre-existing organisms, nothing but this states that the biogenesis, known as abiogenesis. The organic evolution is due to chemical reaction, that was completely relating to one theory of chemical evolution of life. So we can directly discuss that abiogenesis theory was originated in support of spontaneous generation, where the living organisms are existed in a spontaneous manner. So next up, who proposed that first form of life could have come from pre-existing non-living organic molecule? So here, Oparin and Haldane, so scientists who described the chemical evolution of life, but it has been experimentally conducted by the Stanley Miller and Harold Urey. So Stanley Miller conducted an experimental proof conducted by the Oparin and Haldane, the Charles Darwin, who is called as father of evolution. So where Alfred Wallace, who is a naturalist, conducted an voyage for to study the fossil imprints in different continents. So here, the non-living organic molecule that has been helpful for the pre-existing of life, described by scientists named called as Oparin and Haldane. Alfred Wallace, he worked in the name of the island that is called Galapagos Island, Australian Island Continent, Malay Archipelago are none of these. So here, Alfred Wallace, who is a naturalist, they came to the same conclusion concluded by the Charles Darwin. So in an area that is called as Malay Archipelago, it's also an island. So next one, that is the name the organs that these relates to. Example, the thorns of Bougainvillea and the tendrils of Cucurbita. The thorns of Bougainvillea and the tendrils of Cucurbita both have been originated same, but they are performing a different function, nothing but they are the homologous organs. So here, the homologous organs, they are showing a divergent evolution, whereas the analogous organs, they are showing a convergent evolution. So here, the options that have been given, homologous organ, convergent evolution, divergent evolution, option D, that is a both A and C. So those organs are the example for homologous organ. They are showing a divergent evolution also. For the answer is D, that is both A and C. Replacement of lighter colored variety of peppered moth, which is called Distant Betularia, to its darker variety, that is called Distant Corbinifera in England, is an example. So we given an example called Distant Betularia and Distant Corbinifera, that was a natural selection that takes place in an Indian, England, before and after industrialization. So easily we can describe by giving an example called as natural selection. The second step, large mutation, it leads to speciation. So here, the given options are founder effect, saltation, branching distance, and natural selection. So here, mutation is a raw material. So where it has been described by the help of unique primrose by scientists called as Hugo de Vries. So here, when the mutation it occurs in a single step, it was showing numerous variations, that is in a large mutation, the definition that is called as saltation. So answer is option B. So next one, there is a Hardy-Weinberg principle or equilibrium. It states that always the population they are remaining and constant is now to be affected by gene flow, genetic drift, mutation, genetic recombinations. These are the factors that they are affecting the genetic equilibrium. So for the option, that is evolution, limiting factors, saltation and natural selection. So usually, the factors that are affecting the genetic equilibrium was completely depending upon the environmental factor that is called as natural selection. So for that, the seventh question, the option right is D. The primate which existed 15 million years ago. So here, the primate is nothing but the individuals that is called as organisms which are having an erect posture, that is a human brains. So where in 15 million years ago, there are two individuals that are present called as Ramapithecus and Dryopithecus. The given option that is an Homo habilis, Australopithecus, Ramapithecus and Homo erectus. So for this, the eighth, that is the correct option is C, that is called Ramapithecus. The brain capacity of Homo erectus Here, based upon the brain capacity, the human individuals that are also classified into, for example, Homo habilis, Homo erectus, Neanderthal man, Homo sapiens like this. So here, the brain capacity of Homo erectus, it was nearly about 960. This is the right option. Next one, paleontology. That is nothing but the study of fossils. That is the remains of plants and animals which are present in a sedimentary of rocks. So here, paleontology evidence for evolution of life, it refers to the development of embryo. It was completely relating on the embryology. Homologous organ and analogous organs, they are showing a convergent and divergent evolution. So by paleontological evolution, it has been described by these are fossils. So next one, the bones of forelimb of whale, bat, cheetah and man are similar structured because. So here, the forelimb of these individuals, they have been originated seen, even they having an anatomical features like carpals, metacarpals, radius, ulna, they are all similar, but they are performing a different function. That means one organism has given rise to another, they share a common ancestors, they perform the same function, they have biochemical similarities. Here, both they having a similar origin and they are all relating to a species called as mammals. So, thus the option correct is they share a common ancestors. Next, which of the following is an example for linked species? So, one of the species that was linking between a ancestral species and a new species, that is called dogfishes, which is also called coelacanth. They are linking between the amphibians and reptiles. So, this is about an MCQ in this chapter. Thank you so much.